Twitch channel. Hey, sorry I didn't play Friday or Sunday night. I had a conference, so I didn't play those nights. So we are back now again on Tuesday, and my days. And so one of the things I thought to do tonight, because it's a little unusual, is this past weekend was the Global Game Jam. Global Game Jam is a event where teams of amateur developers and game developers get together at different locations around the world, and they have 48 hours to make a game based on a theme that's announced to them at Friday night. So the theme this year was waves. My local or the library that I work at actually was actually a host site for Global Game Jam this year, and so I thought it would be fun to kind of highlight some of the things that they've done, they did, as well as kind of look at some of the other games that were created during this weekend. So I'm going to go through. I have a list of about 22-23 games that I'm going to go through. I'm going to try my best at some of them. I've gone through, I've tried a bunch of them just to kind of see how well the capture software can stream. Most of them are pretty good. Things made in Unity work really well. There's a couple on Unreal that I didn't get the chance to try yet, so we'll see those. But yeah, so we're going to just kind of take a look to see all kind of the creativity of things that people made this weekend. They had 48 hours to make a game, and so now we're going to play them over the next few hours. Yeah, so I am going to be actually sharing out the link to the... I have a shared Google spreadsheet with all the games that has links to the games so you can actually go and download themselves. When I archive this video onto YouTube later, I will also, in the description there, I'll have a list with links to all the games that I played, as well as the ones I may not get to. So let me share this here. Now get into this here. So the first game I'm going to be playing is a game. I'm going to start with actually the I think I have six games from the Fairfield County Game Jam, which is the one that was my local area here. There were eight made, but one of them I just couldn't actually get started to play at all. I couldn't find an executable file. Sorry, I ate dinner, so things are digesting. And the other one I just could not get it to capture with my streaming software. It was made with Game Maker, and for some reason, it just couldn't capture the window or anything on there, so I didn't want to spend too much time on it there. I came back, I spent all day yesterday traveling. I was kind of up a little bit late last night working on this year, so it's, didn't want to spend that much. Some of the other games that I've tested most of these, some of them may not work, though. So we'll see as we go through. That's all part of the fun of this year, see me fail on things. So this first game I'm going to be playing is called Downtown Remix. And so here's the description that the creators did. It's a mixtape named MX Tape is scouring the city streets for inspiration on their new track. Search for sounds within the time limit, dodging enemies and traffic while keeping your balance. Bit super hot fire throughout downtown. So here we go. It'll be a bit before it shows up. I'll wait for it to show up on stream. Go. Okay, so as you can see, it's not the fanciest of games. They had 48 hours to make this year, and some of them have never made games before. So I was really impressed, actually. I was going through what I was able to find. Once again, they had Friday night at 6 p.m. They were everywhere around the world at 6 p.m. Their local time were given the same theme. So around the world. I think when I looked onto the Global Game Jam site, and I could share the link for that there too. I think there was something like 78. No, there was more than that. I can't remember. There was a huge number of games that were made and uploaded to the site there. All of them on this kind of wave theme. So this one here obviously is sound waves that they kind of went with. So let's get into this here. One of the things I found, and it's gonna be kind of interesting, is that. A lot of these games don't have like a clean exit, so I have to Alt F4 out of all of them. Such. Here we go. Get into. This one's really weird because you can see I can move left and right, I jump, and then things tip. And then like, so jumping, me going this way. If I can get myself upright again. Ah, now I'm upside down. Upside down is not good. It's all a matter of trying to, and there's a time, so, yeah, this is not. I think I, all a matter of trying to get myself back. Come on. So apologize for the keyboard sounds. I realized that my, here we go. Okay. Now, problem with the, oh, there we go. Hey! Going the right way again. Okay. Nope. Oh, okay. Okay, so that didn't work. I failed there. So here's the credits. We have Estrus Joey Brutus is the 2D artist. Armando Frias, level design and programmer and animation. Escape to quit. Okay. I don't think I can replay without starting the game again. Okay, so let's try that again. I did get a little bit further last night. It is really tricky because, like, you all of a sudden, like, twist and turn all around. There we go. B. And jump. Okay. And I'm upside down again. Up. There we go. Oh, yay. Oh. No. Hey. There we go. Oh, okay. Okay. If I flip the other way, I can actually jump up the level. Doesn't work here. And I can actually fall off the side of the level, which is not good. Yeah, the balance thing is really kind of quirky. I don't know why they went with that there instead of just making a simple platformer. Let's try that again, why don't we? Okay. Start this. Tonight I'm drinking an Earl Grey. Okay, let's. By the way.
And B.
Here. Oop. Hey. Okay. Oh, nope. Don't tip. Don't. Ah. Oh. Back up. Yay. Now. Up. There we go. Boop. Okay. Hey, I'm actually doing better now than I've actually ever done before. Oh no. Nope. There we go. I'm facing them up. There we go. Okay. Oop. Balance. Oh no. Okay. See, it's when I'm facing this way, because if I go the oh, can you get me over? Okay. Yep, there we go. So now what I can do up. See how I had what I said is I can actually move to the left and jump and actually kind of like fly through the level like Superman. It's a really weird kind of perspective thing. Let's try that one more time. Okay.
B to begin.
And don't tip. Nope. No. Yay. There we go. Yes. Oh. It's when I tip over onto this side. That's the issue. Okay, there we go. Oh. We'll just go upside down. Because I'm a super cool mixtape. They're saying something about shooting super hot fire. I haven't got to that part yet. Okay. I need to use the cars to tip myself. There we go. There we go. So now I can fly. Yeah, except when I do that. No. Or. So well that one time. Yeah, it's really tricky. Something that I think if I spent a really lot of like a lot of time at, I might kind of get the quirks in it. Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah, man. There we go. Okay. Ride the CDs. I don't need those stinky CDs. Ah, there we go. Okay, so now. There we go. And the only problem is now stuck upside down. In between the radios. The boom boxes. So 80s. But I still have time. Let's figure out how to get out of this. There are three controls. There is A, D, and space. So there isn't a lot of action. Oop, is the world turning? As the world turns. Okay. One more time? Yeah, let's do one more time. One more time. And then we'll move on to the next game. I'm kind of captivated by, like, mastering. I think this might be a game that might actually, like, sit on my desktop for a while, and I'll just kind of, like, randomly open it. And see if I can do better. Oh no! He get caught. Uh oh. Oh, I'm getting eaten by the CDs. By the CDs, no! Oh, there we go. They helped me. And up. Oh! Hold on, hold on. No, not that way! There we go. And jump! No! Uh oh. Okay, hold on. Maybe they can help me. Yep. Maybe can help me. There we go. Okay. I'm facing. This is the way that's the problem to face. CDs. Are you going to help me? There you go. Just be enemies, I think. But they kind of. Oh, nope. Hey. There we go. Oh. Yes. Oh, bounce. Okay. I think that's enough of that game tonight. So that was Downtown Remix. Next is a game called It Never Ends. Never End. Things to okay, so. The description of this game is, our game is a wave defense game. An endless amount of enemies try to destroy the objective while you try to intercept them before they can do so. You also have the option to click power-ups to help in your campaign. So they took the wave theme and they made it into a wave defense game. This one's interesting. I think this is control. This one never ends. Start. Another one made in Unity. Wait. Boom. See, I have to these things. This is something, ooh, made me bigger. That's good, yeah. And I have to make sure they don't hit Earth. Saving Earth! The waves of asteroids. I did a little bit of this last night. Learned that it is best to kind of stay close to the planet. No! Oh, this is kind of, oh no! Things. Oh, that's right. I get a power up at one point that allows me to actually travel through the planet, which is really nice because it allows me to easily kind of. Oh, this is the kind of game. There we go. This is not good. That I could see like people picking up like Agar.io or something. a little bit more polish and much better tonight than I did last night. I guess I have to watch out for those yellow ones. Yellow ones are the fat ones. Okay, I am doing much better tonight than I did last night.
Boom, boom.
Love the sounds. It's a very satisfying sound. That, when they all blow up, that's really satisfying. Sorry for the mouse pointer stuck in there. Ah, no, not the yellow. No, okay. Ooh. Go away, yellow. No, not the green. There we go.
Boom.
Okay. I don't know. Sometimes I don't know what these things do. Sometimes I know they speed me up. No, no, no. Oh, okay. Oh, good. I'm doing remarkably better than I did last night. One of the neat things about these Game Jam games is that not only are they just kind of all there, it's a great place to go if you're just looking for fun little games to play, but they also, a lot of them have their source code available. So you can kind of go in and see, oh, how did they do this? Uh-oh. No, not yet. Oh, okay. The final score, 519.238. I have no idea what I was scoring on there. Time elapsed, 158 seconds. Let's try that again. This one here doesn't have a quit. It just allows you to restart. This one uses arrow keys. Oh, get the mouse out of the way.
Boom. Boom. Boom.
Let's see what the power up gives me. It makes me faster. Speed. Speed is key. Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay. No. Okay, let's see. Doom. When I was bigger. Let's see. Oh, I got big again. Yay, because now I'm actually bigger than... Oh, no, not the yellows. Grays are slow. I can ignore those for a while until there ends up being too many of them. Yes. Boom. Okay, I'm actually having a lot more fun with this tonight than I did last night when I was testing it out. This actually feels like just like a really classic arcade game. I mean, it's just a very simple mechanic that is easy to understand, easy to do. It's really not that easy. Because it's all just arrow keys moving around, and it doesn't move that smoothly. Or it's, there's like a, I don't know if it's like a weight to the item or a moment. But like changing directions or having to go around the planet makes it a little bit.
Boom.
Oh. Oh, did I put a shield around the planet? I think I may. Nuke is now available. Oh, okay. Is it telling me what the updates are? Oh, double score. Oh, now it's telling me. I missed what that. You know, this entire time I didn't even notice that it was telling me what the, bigger paddle. Okay, bigger paddle, yeah. This entire time I didn't know it was actually telling me what the upgrades were. Nuke. Oh my god, I feel dense. Not having noticed that before. Score. Okay, double score is good. No, no, no! Oh! Sometimes there's like a weird repul- like a repelling field or something. I don't remember that. Bigger panel, I already have. Paddle. need to get the paper. I need to get the big. Oh no, I'm gonna. Okay. Oh. Go. Nuke. And of course, you'll ask, when does this end? But as the game title told us, it never ends. Oh no! Make sure I. Because these yellows are the thing to watch. They're fast little buggers. Oh no! Oh. Okay, nope, down 40. Okay, and. Bingo! Oh, no, 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 freeze! Green. Nuke! Nuke! There we go. That don't have to work. Hard. Wooly, you can't get past me. Nuke him. Bigger paddle, okay. Double score. I'll take it. Oh, yeah, Duke. 1776 is my score. Great year. Great, states declared independence from England, Great Britain at that time. Came up. Of course, then we had to go fight a war about it. Oh, oh no, okay. No, oh. No. Oh. Crisp. Nuke would be nice. Uh-oh. Double score. Nuke. Woohoo. Out of 10 health. One more hit. And Earth, it goes kablooey. More. Oh no, I missed it. They have a time limit on them. I didn't know that. Oh no, no. Oh. Okay, so that was This Never Ends. A clean quit. So It Never Ends. Next up is a game called Ninja Exote. I'm not really quite sure. It's N-I-N-J-A. You'll see it. And Ninja Zote. This year is Bob is an office worker with a grandiose dream to be a ninja. One day his dream goes too far. He suddenly believes he is a ninja, master of the waves, able to run on water. Little does he know he's still at the office. Launch this. Need to actually. Oh, this is the one that was in the Game Maker Studio. Okay, there we go. I just had to change the source that was streaming here. This whole thing tonight is going to be kind of a work in progress as I'm working. The controls does not do anything. The game. Okay, there we go. Apparently, I need to. Bob snaps back to reality. Okay. It's because I. Oh, there we go. Let's use his arrow keys again. Okay. I throw shurikens! So, this is basically kind of a side scrolling shooter. Running across the waves. And I wonder if this is a game of Bob actually, like, going on a murderous rampage in his office. Because, as you notice, when I kill them, they all turn back into office workers. And, so I wonder, is he really throwing ninja stars at his coworkers? Which makes this a very morbid, dark game. It's also not particularly difficult. But that doesn't take anything away from kind of the, just the technical level needed to make this year. I mean, doing this stuff in 48 hours isn't easy, especially if you've never made a game before. These aren't going to be AAA polished games. These aren't going to be some of like the great indie games out there. This is entertaining. The sounds are fun. This is the longest I've actually played this. So I don't know if it ever gets to an end. Do I get to a boss? Or is it just like endless waves on the waves of co-workers that Bob is brutally murdering with his ninja stars, pretending to be a ninja? No, the artwork isn't too bad. It's fun. So how much longer of this do I go? Anybody have an idea? Oh, that's... Yeah, let's... There we go. Bob snaps back to reality. So that was Ninja Zote. We're going to quit. Not much more to that game to show, and don't really need to spend much more time. So that's Ninja Zote, another one made here at the Fairfield County Global Game Jam. And now, onto a game called Snuggle Smugglers. Kind of a cute little game name. And so the description on this one here is, it's up to you, Captain Pretty Whiskers. Navigate your ship through rough waters full of invisible torpedoes to deliver precious resources to war-torn motherland. Use sonar to dodge the enemies along your path. This one is actually really tough. Another one here. Obviously. Unity was one of the big... There we go. Snuggle Smuggler. Okay, so click to start. Okay, French rats have discovered our position. We must finish our journey across the Niltic Sea without light. WASD keys. Press W and S up to 4 times to increase speed. Hold A and S to turn. Click the left mouse button to trigger sonar detection. Feel hidden torpedoes lurking in the water. Eve-ho! So this here is my sonar. Now, what happens is, because we're turning, it's like, this is another game where it takes a little bit to really kind of figure out. Oh, boom, boom, boom. Yeah. Oh no, the ship is sunk. Play again. Okay. Yeah, it's, I mean, you have to have faster speed to turn quickly. But you still don't turn quickly. It's very much, oh, I'm gonna hit the rocks. Oh no, I didn't. Okay. I don't know what the sonar actually does. That's the waves on the ocean as well as sonar waves. Yeah, this one's actually a tough game because the turning is like, ooh. Like right now, I'm fastest speed I can go, and it's just like. No, okay. There's like no way I can like dodge these things. I mean, I'm fastest speed, which gives us me the shortest turn radius. Oh, yay! Congratulations, you won! Didn't do that before. I didn't know how far I had to go. So basically just kind of playing across the game board there. We go a little slowly. Oh no, torpedoes. Faster. Engine's hit. Uh-oh, the ship is sunk. I don't know what hit me. Did I run onto ground? Do it again. Hey. That's pretty music, though. Oh no, I'm gonna hit by the torpedo. Ow. No, torpedoes, go away. I don't really know what the sonar actually. Ugh.
We do.
Oh. Hey. Back a bit, yeah. There we go. Okay, go this way and. Full speed ahead! Oh, torpedo! Okay. Oh, no, 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 the torpedo's gonna hit me! Okay, and. Oh, 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 don't hit the rocks. Rocks! Yeah, as I was kind of looking through a lot, there's a lot of themes using sonar, echolocation, kind of that theme of like sound waves and light waves. So that was Snuggle Smugglers. Kind of fun little game. It does take a little bit of work trying to figure out how to actually steer that chip around. But that was kind of cute. Okay, the next one we have from the Fairfield County Game Jam is a game called Space Warriors. And the only description for this one here is space shooting game. With Unity. Okay, so I can fly, move, fire, and apparently I have begin. Oh. Apparently, I don't actually like destroy the robots, but I kind of make them kind of suicidal, and they run off the. They don't run off the edges until I shoot them. Okay, it's like a repeller wave or something. Okay. Yeah. I have a jetpack. You off, I'm gonna push you off. Aha! Yep, go off to yay! Okay, that's kind of a fun little bit. Yep, yarr, there you go. Cute little, spaceman sprite. Yeah, just kind of a basic little platformer. The flying kind of makes it very easy. I don't have to worry about actually like jumping. Yeah, I come down very slowly. That's really catchy music. More robots to shoot. Shoot all the robots. Wave Invaders. Okay, so the game said Space Warriors, now it's called Wave Invaders. Let's do that again. Yep, okay, yep. Off it up, up, up. I push the other side. Woo! And see, the thing is that mainly they have to try to get a like an executable by 6 p.m. on Sunday. So a lot of times the games aren't the sometimes there's a lot more debugging that needs to be done. They're not the perfectly polished games, but you know what? They made a game. Or I'm gonna keep pushing you. Like right now I don't think I am actually like losing life when I hit them. There didn't seem to be any threat. So it is fun to watch them kind of scurry in and like. I mean, there's like a skeleton of like a good game in this. Find an end. I think I missed the trigger point to make it end. there we go. Okay, so yeah, that was Wave Invaders / Space Warriors. Okay, and so the final one that I got working from the Fairfield County Mobile Game Jam is a Waving Prototype. This really isn't a game. It was, I think, made by one. Two people. Made by two people. So it's not like a full game or anything, but it's cute. I had fun annoying my girlfriend with this one. Called Wave Prototype. Basically, I just use my wave. Get the little robot guy here. Left click and mouse move mouse to wave. Hi! Hello! Hello! I can see you, or you can see me. I can't see anybody who's watching this. Hello! Over here! Oh, over here! Is it on the left? Is it on the right? Oh no! I can do a handstand! Doing my push-ups! Pull-ups! Pull-ups! Hello! Hello over there! Wave, 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 wave. So, this meets the theme of wave, is that the robot's waving at you. Hello! Hello! Now we're going to say goodbye to the Fairfield County Global Game Jam Games. Goodbye! Bye! So yeah, that's that. Okay, so enough silliness, and let's get on to some more games. Okay, so the next game on my list here, a game called Go. This is actually, when I was testing this around last night, this is a really tough game. Really interesting, but kind of difficult. So the description of this game is, first-person suspense game, you are a blind child using wave sonar to navigate through the house to find your favorite toy. All the while, you must avoid the monster who is listening for your every move. And so basically, you hear the monster, you stay still, and the monster can't find you. If you stay still too long, he will find you. This is one of the more polished games that I came across when I was looking. So the games that I chose were I just kind of was browsing through, finding a bunch of things that could be on Windows. They made for Windows. People did all sorts of things with the game jam. They did people board games, card games. There's a whole bunch of like VR experiences that people did using virtual reality, things for the Vive, for the Oculus Rift. If I dug in, I could probably find some things that would be on the PlayStation. A whole range of kind of developers doing a bunch of different things. But so this is Tiptoe. I'm blind, but this wave sonar.
What was that?
Over there. That. Oh, the red over there. That is the monster apparently. Walls. Terrifying. Oh, the red. The monster's coming this way. I wish I could strafe. Oh, there he is. No.
Sounds big. What is that?
Kind of tense. Oh, and he got me. Now I'm back to the room. Come out, I'm trying to find my toy.
Wait, don't move.
Where was it? Oh.
What was was that? Lamb chop?
It has a frightening imagining.
What was that? Lamb chop? Lamb chop?
Turning around. What's happening? Stuck.
Lamb chop.
Spinning around. Good. See anything?
That sounds big.
Hit you.
What was that?
Get the.
Wait! Don't move. Lamb chop?
Get the toy. Get back to my room.
Wait, oh. Don't move. Wait, don't move.
Coming this way. I am so tense right now. Oh, he's coming. He's coming. In the bathroom. Run. Run, little kid. Here. Scary mofo.
What was that?
Oh, he sees me. Okay. Got me. Ooh, okay.
Wait, don't move. That sounds big.
Ooh. Oh, and I had him too.
That sounds big. What was that?
really does give you a sense of, like, helplessness. Because you're reliant upon these sound waves to be able to see.
Wait, don't move.
Oh, he's that way. Oh no, no. Ooh, lamb chop. I'm stuck. Oh. Okay. That's tense enough. Finish some of that game.
Big.
Yeah, it's fun. I definitely recommend. Out of a lot of the ones, this is definitely one to kind of go take a look at. See if you can do it. Okay. So, with this, and we'll move on to the next game. Next game, a game called Oscillo Boy. Like an oscilloscope. That's actually. Okay, so Oscillo Boy is an endless runner on waves. Oscilloscope. Here's actually, I mean, it's clever. You have the picture of the oscilloscope here. So we zoom. Okay, here's. Zoom in. Oop. Yeah, I can jump. Basically, give yourself a going. Or if you get stopped by hitting a wall like that. Okay. Yeah, just a very basic platformer. Jump over gaps, jump over walls. Don't fall into the pits. Oh, that was close. Oh, and it's going faster. Oh. Okay, apparently I can jump way off the top of the screen. Who knew? Random generation every time. So that's Oscillo Boy, 2000. Okay, I have to hold that for here. The next game we have a game called Spira de Aquatica. And so the description of Spira. Okay, so Spira, Levi the Plesiosaur, always longed to be a legendary creature. Great Island Turtle Mino Game. If he can collect 7 relics from the ruins on his back, he can rise to stand in the light of Mino Game with his own mythical ruins on his back. So, we have a Plesiosaur.
Isn't he cute?
Ooh. Didn't know I could get up to the top. I tried this last time, but couldn't get up. Bubbles make me go faster. And once. through that way again. Got a piece. Here we go. A little backpack now for Levi the Plessy. These pearl like above now. Can't go. Side of the. Oh wait, no, there we go. Okay. Sorry, I don't need to breathe the air. Yeah. Free. There we go. The boot. All just very okay. 13 onwards. What do you mean onwards? Wait a minute. Oh. What are you? Big fish. Beams trap. Ah, fish. Final Fantasy. Here, look at dungeon music. Burnt. Alan. Up again. He took one of my things. Fish took one of my things. Well, I'm very fast, am I? My thing. I had the little thing over that. Big turtle! I'm the turtle! Be just like you! Fish took one of them. Do that again? Try again? I go a little bit faster. Most of. The cracks. Probably them like in that section. There's the arc thing, energy, followed by the fish later on. Wait a second. It's anymore. Oh, that must be a glitch in the game. There's a turtle. Oh, turtle. Oh, plesiosaur. Turtle. Look, Charlie. It's a plesiosaur. That is Spyro de Aquatica. Okay, so the next game we're going to look at is a game called Apukohai's Wave. Apologize if I. Okay, so the description of this game here is. Defend your island from hordes of the shark god's minions. This kind of... This kind of person view, and a little bit different. Are Kyla, the only remaining warrior of Kauai. Using these three harpoon ballistas positioned on the beach alongside fortifications, you must save Kauai from the emergency. Oh, somebody came to me here. Where did he go? I come with my ear. Thank you. where I'm aiming it. Need too low. Grab a hand. Hey, got him. Ballistic. I'm going to die. Yep, I'm going to die very soon. Game over. Okay, should we try again? Let's try again. And I'll to like set his dead. Kyla. Ow. I'm doing the whole move in my... That guy. Yep, there we go. So that was Apukohai's wave. A little bit difficult. Probably if I spent more time with it. I was starting to somewhat get the hang of it, but. Okay, so the next game I'm going to look at is a game called Mariana. Another, like, undersea. This one here, if you do go follow the link to go download it, don't download the executable. It's missing the data file. Get the source code, and in there there's the .exe with the data file. Another one made. So Mariana, explore the depths, the sea in a lonely submarine. View your surroundings using sonar beeps. Explore and find samples to bring. However, be careful to avoid the creatures as well here. Your hearing is very sensitive and won't take kindly to your trespassing. We got Mariana. Bing. Bing. Trying to. See, so dark. Mariana Trench. I need sonar beep. Features. Hit me. Then you're just weird, because when it comes back to this, see how see everything. This we go in the wrong. Titanic. Everything. Okay, the game.
Boom.
I think when I something. Okay. Put that out and. Now I know a better idea to go down rather than see what happens then.
Good whale. Green. Good.
Signal. Yeah. Down. Yep, there we go. Bottom of the map.
I didn't need it.
Yep. Okay.
Doesn't wait.
He, like, all of a sudden the ship starts moving. Screen scrolling. Cave that we That's Mariana. Game that has potential was cool, but I don't think they ever kind of meet there. Pretty and kind of a neat game, actually. Try that. Not actually. Flip room. It actually looked. So you're trapped inside a cube and you got to get out. Game level is a cube. You can rotate and use gravity to move objects around the world to help you make it to the like an inside of a cube. I'm guessing the wave theme on this one here is gravity. Gravity wave. I'm not a judge, so theme or anything. Unity was a big sponsor of Jam. It's one of the most available and accessible bins. They have a cool QE to rotate. Okay, so you... pretty standard. Oh. Oh. Guy. I'm a little monkey. Oh, and I just fell off the edge. Bye. Working as well. Cool. Done. I guess I'm done with this. Echoes. And so this is another one where they decide to go with the echo sonar wave, sound wave theme. And this one here, that. That's with little squeaks where I can. They're blind. The description here is eat bugs and use your echolocation to navigate through the caves and find your family. A lonely pet. Echo. Echoes song. Nom, nom, nom. Platformer? Oh, I see. Okay, so eating the bugs. Spider. Spider. Yeah. I just had to see what happened. You've lost your way. Try again. Bug. Certain number of sonar pulses. I see. This is a clever game. I like this. By a spider that I couldn't see. Not worth yeah, after that. Oh, cool. Oh, that's... Oh, crap. Okay. I have to say, I think this is probably one of the favorites, my favorites that I've done, so... Oh, wings hit him. One more shot? Yeah, let's try it again. If I can get past her. On all the yummy flies. I don't know what a spider do to a bat. Probably eat. Another one that I deal that with kind of practice. I get here, like I'm able to get through there here a lot without. Hey, I made it past that spider this time. There's a big spider over there. Oh my god. Ooh. I have no more pulses. I can't see where the big spider is. This is bad. Oh well. Leroy Chickens! I don't know if I'm playing or I'm... There we go. I was got somewhere. But yeah, so that was Echo's song. I might go back to and kind of play around a little bit. That was kind of fun. Gorgeous, kind of neat little music kind of going on. Good mechanic, just kind of some standard flying, platforming, dodging, and kind of that memory kind of thing. You saw the spider, you remember where it was, but they move. Force management, fun. The next game, kind of a puzzle game. Called J. Weatherman Jr. I had meant to do a lot more of this. Oh well. Okay, so J. Weatherman Jr. In J. Weatherman Jr., players predict the forecast by inputting instrument data in a real 3D environment. Data of the little seaside town will be determined by the accuracy of J's prognosis. This is one where I actually have to like read weather instruments. At least from, because there was more of a description, I didn't copy it all. I have to read weather instruments and forecast the weather for the next day. And if I do it correctly, everything's okay. But if I do it incorrectly, like people like sailors die because they properly predict the storm that sends up onto them onto the rocks. See if I can do this. I like kind of logic solving like this. Okay. Start a game. Okay.
wind blowing. What is going on? Try that again. I don't get that very far in this game. Okay. Oh. So. Okay, so yep, not click. Probably would have kept me down there. Something weird is happening. Camera here. Oops. Okay. New. Days. Okay, it's re- have fun. Hell. Well, I thought this was a fun game. The fact that I can't seem to do anything in it. Except change the days. And I can go. Yep. Same. It was a neat concept. Can't do anything with it. The next game. Bum bum bum. Okay. Game we're going. It's called Handshake Simulator. Okay, so Handshake Simulator. Take control of a hand, trying to shake its way to the top. Very simple controls complete a variety of handshakes before your confidence runs out. So this is all the kind of weird, kind of mean handshake kind of things. I can... Yeah. Let's see what happens here. Handshake! Includes 3 exclamation points. Okay, handshake! Boom! Okay. Oh my. Oh. My. Okay. B. B. Oh wait. Elbow. Oh, wrist. The wrist. G-H-J-K-L. Something's going down. I don't know. Oh, wait. Nothing is working. Okay. Handshake. Okay. Okay. Okay, I get it now. Oh my god. Elbow. No. Cool. need to rotate my hand. Oh, okay. There we go. Rotate. Oh, oh. I don't think my fingers are supposed to do that. My fingers are not supposed to do that. Ow! Ow! Okay, so close that. My thumb's not supposed to do that either. And I've just... Oh, okay. Let's put that back. Let's put the thumb in. Okay, and now... This book, that's not right. Confidence lost. Oh, I took too long. Because I was having too much fun breaking my, Okay, so that's high five. Okay, let's see. E, yes, okay. No. Rotate. Yeah, there we go. Hey! No. Oh my god. What's going on? Here we go. Oh. The confidence is right. Ah, there we go. Boop. Hey. Oh. Close. Yeah, confidence. Oh, wait, seriously? Oh, handshake. Yeah, something screwed up there. Okay. Okay, this I can do. Handshake. 4 exclamation points. Okay. Okay, so we have a fist bump again. Okay, so we need to. Oh no. It's just there we go. Okay, so got that. Let's get the dear god. Oh, don't put the thumb that way. Okay, so how do I get my wrist? Ah, there we go. How do I get the... Oh, there we go. It's here. I did it. Fist bump. Fist bump. Hey, I did it. Fist bump, bro. Okay, high five. High five, I think I can do this. Yeah, okay, let's burn it. Okay, yeah, okay, got that. Yay, okay. Hey. Oh, no. Okay. Hey, there we go. Handshake. I think. Okay, so it's just the 3 handshakes. Okay, we can quit this now. Yeah, so that was Handshake Simulator. Those controls, oh my god, they say simple controls. Well, once you start never mind. Okay. We're moving on to the next game. The next game is a game called Exit, Pursued by Bear. This game, the title comes from a stage direction in Shakespeare's play, A Winter's Tale. The interesting trivia about the stage direction is it is the only stage direction Shakespeare wrote in his plays. Every single one of his plays, there are no actual written stage directions. Any stage directions that you see if you go see a Shakespeare play are decided upon by the director to do. except for the case of A Winter's Tale, in which a character, I think, what is it, Antigonus, exits the scene pursued by a bear. Completely random. Winter's Tale, it's an interesting story. I can't remember all the details, but yeah. A character basically exits pursued by a bear, and it's assumed that the bear eats him. I think it gets mentioned again later in the play about his unfortunate death. So the description of this game, get it going. So while it's doing that there, you can get. That's always fun. There we go. You are not. You. Because it's not coming in full screen, so therefore my capture is not grabbing it. There we go. Exit pursued by bear. The game. Okay, actually, let me just. It so you can see everything. There you go. Yeah, I'm sorry about the black border kind of things around and such. I mean, I have this set mainly to do gaming. Okay, so exit pursued by bear. The description. In this game, you're an actor portraying Antigonus in Shakespeare's play A Winter's Tale. Unfortunately for you, your vengeful understudy has released waves of actual bears upon the stage direction. Exit, pursued by bear. Fight back hordes of bears as you try to deliver lines, any line, with poise and grace. Start game. What's the difference between starts game and ready? Okay, let's start game. We'll come back and see what ready. Okay, oh, the story. You are the talented actor, Bera Fawcett. Ecstatic to be playing the role of Antigonus in William Shakespeare's play The Winter's Tale. After abandoning the baby Perdita in the woods under the orders of the king, you are prepared to make your grand exit. You see that this play is known for the famous stage direction, Exit, pursued by bear, and you are ready to make the exit a memorable one. Alas, your evil understudy has been plotting your demise since callbacks. Much to your dismay and surprise, the scoundrel has unleashed waves of actual bears upon the stage to make sure your exit is a permanent one. To make matters worse, these bears don't even seem to know which play they're in. Foil the villain's treacherous plot by fighting back, use the stage and sets to your advantage, and avoid a grisly death. Maybe you can even deliver a few monologues while you're at it. Antigonus may not have any more lines, but that doesn't mean you can't ad-lib something, and if you don't keep the audience entertained, they'll surely thirst for blood. It can be even scarier than the bear sometimes. Click or press space to continue. Okay, WASD keys to move, space to jump, click to attack, right click to activate object, shift to deliver a monologue, don't die. And don't buy drugs from the tree guy. I will. Oh my. Oh. Whoa. Yay, oh my god, look at, bear! Bear! Bear, bear, oh, ow. What is this? What are these things? I don't know. Oh, they're throwing things at me. That's what's happening. Die, bear. That is a fake beast. Witch! Witch! Say some lines! Say some lines! Ow! Throwing things at me! I don't know if I have life or anything. Wait, is this the fake bear? The audience is not pleased. There's a villainous bear up here. Villainous bears, and I'm off the screen. Pause. Oh, pause. Oh, there I am. Say some lines. Okay, I'm falling. Ow. Say some lines. Log. I'm gonna buy some drugs from the tree guy. Wow.
Bears have three heads. Okay. Like Winnie the Pooh. I have no idea what's going on anymore. Game over. Your final score is 1. Alas. Ready? Oh, right click to activate an object. Okay, it wasn't doing that. Okay. I don't get the koala. What's going on? Okay, can I? Can I get back onto? Audience is not very happy. Can I get back onto the stage? Throwing things at me. There's like sandbags. Oh wait, there I am. I'm back on stage. I'm supposed to have a life somewhere, life meter somewhere. Confused at what's going on. I'm just gonna keep swinging with my sword and saying some monologues. I can. So confused. I have no idea what I'm doing. I'm just clicking randomly and making speeches. I don't know if I'm the one bleeding or they're the ones bleeding. Okay, it's a witch. Clicking out of the window all the time. All the speeches. Pogo sticks and the witches, witch bears. Okay, I'm killing some things. I'm doing something. I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm doing something. I haven't died yet. Not that I have a life meter, so I have no concept of. I really don't know what I'm doing. Play some speeches. Back you, Phantom of the Koala Bears. Speeches! Speeches! I don't think I'm on the screen anymore. I don't know where I'm at. Speeches! Okay. Can I get back? Speeches! Not on the stage, actually. Come on. Come on. This way. This way, I can do this. I can't see myself. I have no idea what's, we're done with exit the bear. Okay. That's executed by bear. Next up, some. Okay, so Prism is a 3D puzzle platformer wherein the player must cycle through various wavelengths of light in order to traverse Prism Tower and uncover its hidden secret. It uses wave as light waves and wavelengths. It sounded intriguing. The idea that I have to kind of like switch spectrums of light to be able to kind of press the platformer. Goes. Graphics card. Fastest. Very excited. There we go. Prism. Enter. Isn't that a pretty title screen? Okay. Okay. Mouse. Standard. Press E. Okay. I mean, I don't see anything. But I'm in blue. In the blue, it's sort of like waving like an ultraviolet light over seeing the invisible ink. And this tells me to press E direction, so then this is the door. So it's... the time for level is here. Do this in 48 hours? This is it. Oh, okay, that's clever. I still have to do this. Okay, so
to. Outside. Fluid. Up. There. Boom. Back up. Bed and jump. So I can red. Okay. I like this cover. Here, switch to. About first person. I don't see that. So I really don't like flat. Maybe we go around. As Jake said to Roland, drop down the ship. Go now, for other worlds than. Yeah. Unless. Colors? Goes back to the planet. I am a complete failure to be able to jump. Piece of shit. Maybe. Impressive. And though. This is a very clever conceit. Pretty as this platforming is.
Come on. I would see more, but really frustrating. They have. Red and bombers. Oh, 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 stay, stay. Okay, we've made some progress. Nope. 11:30. Enough time. Might have to go back to that. Might be another one that'd be, I think, worth going back to. But right now. No, oh, no. Game. I'm gonna, game called Node. And I'm sorry I don't have like all of the information. The game and which teams they are. It's all on the game gems. So I did share in the channel feed, shared document, all the information for you, title and the URL for these games. So if you're interested in going there yourself, welcome to. As I said also at the beginning, archived on YouTube like I do with all the videos. YouTube/Twitter/Yeah. So this will be on there and in the description, the video description, all of these games, links, go download them. So Node is a techno-themed puzzle game requiring players to think about the sound wave, navigate through levels and sound-emitting nodes, factory, hole. Falling into my game. So again, the theme, this is more sound waves. Sorry for the audio. Long day. They traveled all day, work all day today. Unfortunately, I have to go to work late tomorrow night, so. Okay, so. Right here. Day. Page one, attractive tutorial. Okay, I have to get the little ball to the goal over there. Got it. Okay. Also. There we go. Okay. Also did. Okay, this game, I like this game, this is clever. Cool. Okay. I'm getting it. Oh. Okay. I think I'm getting it. I can fail on. Pick this up. Oh, it just. Almost had it. Okay, let's get again. Oh, okay. Yay! I finally figured it out. Down for. Oh! Oh, this is clever. I like this. Okay. Oh boy. Oh my, okay. Sharp. I like this. Oh, too sharp. Too sharp. Oh. Okay. Thank you.
Oh, I almost had it. Okay. Okay, I think this might be favorite game tonight so far. Ah. Oh. Okay. Really like exactly my type, but we need to move on. Oh, yeah. Okay, so we're at 5. Let's move on and see what happens. Oh, okay, I get it. Need to use. Oh, so close. So. Nope, we're gonna hit the wall. Oh, okay. I think this is a clever game. Okay, enough. We need to move on. But yeah, okay. Go take a look at credits because this game, I really like what the. This is probably a game I'm gonna come back and spend. Down. It's fun. Simple idea, but really nice kind of execution that there. That's the great thing, is these little tiny teams together these games. 48 hours. Look at how much fun I'm having with it. Okay, so the game we're going to look at is called Rhythm Hell. Which probably suggests Rhythm. Once again, we're dealing with sound waves. So inspired by sound waves, our game is a rhythm game in a top-down space setting. Stay in beat with music to defend against assaulting enemies while charging up your energy to release a sound wave, clearing out incoming threats. Okay. I apologize if the last game wasn't full screen size. I didn't touch to that. Okay. Yes. Heard. Okay, so Rhythm Hell. A, W, D, or arrow keys. Space bars. Arrow keys for this. Let's see what happens. Oh. Oh, okay, I get it. Okay.
Okay, I got it. I was completely doing it wrong before. Okay. Okay, this is kind of clever. Three! Yes, I did it! I actually beat a rhythm game. That was actually really well done. I like that. Again, very simple, but I really like that. That was kind of neat. That has potential to kind of, I think, now the background was just kind of like movie before my eyes, actually, from kind of paying attention. Yeah, that was Rhythm Hell. That was fun. I did a lot better at that than I thought I would. Okay, so the next game we'll look at is called The Last. And almost near the end of the year. Surprisingly, they've actually all been playing pretty well. Good work, Game Jammers. Note. Okay. So The Last Note, a deaf songwriter. So, like Beethoven, reminisces on the story of his life while creating his magnum opus, based on a whole note he drew as a child. Control his last note, written in, rekindle his passion in music, and help him complete this one final song. It's nice that there's a little bit of a narrative behind there. Once again, we're looking at the sound wave idea here. Waves. We have some other games that I tried to find to see if I could find any surfer games. I didn't dig that. I went about 7 or 8 those games. Found a bunch of stuff. Made in a different game. That again. There you are. Okay. 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 the game. Kind of fine. So we'll just look at the scenery as we go by. Oop, there's stuff. Okay, let's go. Fly up, up, up the mountain. Okay. Is that microphone picking things up? I can't tell. Spot checks on it here. Oop, oh. Sorry about that. Okay, is that better? Stars. Pretty, the music's nice. Not very much game element to it. Backdrop. There's a light in the tunnel. Okay. All black is. Okay. Something like the. I'm really confused. Into the end of the backdrop. And the music's kind of pretty. But other than that, more. The only description that I got from this one here is emitters and waves bouncing sound. Very similar to Node in a way. Kind of. If I think started up stop so many things that it's on. Let's see. I think I'm gonna do. Then we'll call it a night. Okay, so this is ooh. Clever. Okay, let's you guys here.
do a chain of these things. Let's just. And stop. I don't know if they'll stop, actually. I don't think they can stop. Just start, like, things. That was resonance. That was kind of clever. Definitely need some more controls into the interface there to delete things that are on the board. But other than that, that was kind of a clever idea, kind of sounding sound waves. I mean, somebody who's really good at designing something like that could probably do something really cool. I'm not that person. Okay, so the next game we're going to look at is a game called Audition. Okay, so Audition is, here's the description. Musician versus conductor. Engage in an epic musical battle between a young musician and a seasoned conductor. Prove you have musical prowess to prepare a spot in the orchestra. Utilize your college-educated knowledge of music theory to change the amplitude and frequency of your notes to counter the conductor's wicked power chords. Wield a classic selection of electric guitar, trombone, and saxophone. I feel like I should, like, dig out my glasses a bit. Oh. Yeah, unfortunately, I am going to close that. I did not know that the game was going to be actual music like that. And I don't want to have to deal with any copyright infringement things. Probably something I'm going to go back to and play. Here. Apologize. We're going to move on to a game called Ditzy G. I will read the description. In Ditzy Witchy, you play as a klutzy witch who has gotten herself into some trouble. Help Ditzy cast spells to aid her on her journey. I'm not really sure how the wave thing works on this, but for the fact I did look at this last night. It was, you end up on the ocean. So, let's see. Cozy Game Pals. Okay. Isn't she cute? Cute little cat assistant there. Okay, so. And for my next trick, I will disappear before your eyes. Alakazam! There she goes. Oops, there's our waves. Oh, Ditzy is stuck in the ocean. Whoops! This was not supposed to happen. I could cast a spell to make a life buoy. And so now I get to trace the thing here to make spells. Yeah, I've never been very good at coloring in lines. It's a snowman! Shoot. My wand must be faulty. Are you sure your wand would, Dizzy? I'll try a boat this time. Okay. Snowman's. Boat. We get a raft. Close enough. You. Oh, she's taking the snowman with her. Hey there. You okay? Can I call you Snowy? Oh. Oh no! You're melting. or snowy. Maybe a snow cone will help. Because that's what I think of. I mean, I would have thought like an umbrella or a freezer. Yeah, I'm facing that. But he still got his ice cream cone. Darn, it's an ice cream. Hope you're not lactose intolerant. Let's get you to the ice pole before you melt. A sail should do the trick. A lot of tracing. Up, over, and... Yay! The spell actually worked. Yay! On we go. You done eating? Now I'm hungry. Oh, he dropped his cone. I know! I'll spear a fish. Or fishy. Fish. Oh, whoops. Food is food. Really, Ditsy? The mermaid. Just speared Ariel. And you're just saying food is food? Oh. Ew. Ew. Don't judge me, Snowy. But I'm judging you. Ditsy, I'm judging you on this. Hey, oh, we have a ship. Look, something. Rescue. Okay, let's see. We're saved! No! It's a pirate ship! Party. You can't see what it says on the... Quick! I need a paddle to row away. Okay. I don't think this is going to be a paddle. Why does this keep happening? Because you're not good at casting spells, Ditsy. Let's explode the ship then. Party cruise. Happy Pirate Day. You know, they could have just been sailing along. That was close. They could have just been sailing along, having a good time. Probably didn't even see you out there on your little raft. But they'll have to blow him up. Or one violent little witch. Snowy, we're almost there. An iceberg! I'll need to smash it. Are you drawing Monier? Is she gonna be worthy enough to wield him? It is Monier. Crack. She was worthy enough. Even after eating the mermaid and blowing up the poor innocent pirates? Well, okay. Yay! Sail along. Oh, we're on an ice floe. Ice pole! The ice pole. We made it! Aww. And... Oops! Ta-da! The end. So I guess Ditsy freezes her little buns off the ice pole. I don't think there's anything more for me to do. I think I need to, again, another game needs to have kind of an elegant way to quit, aside from Alt-F4. Okay, so we're looking at two more games. This next game is called Resonance, as opposed to... Download. As opposed to Resonance, I forget to download. Okay, I guess I forgot. Quickly. Now the fun stuff of doing all this live, isn't it? Older.
Okay, there we go. All downloaded. All better. Next time I do something like this, I think I'll be a bit more prepared. Again, I spent all day yesterday traveling and late and whatever. Okay, so the description of this game. Resonance is a single-player puzzle game that asks you to manipulate frequencies in order to create a wave that resonates with Gaia's celestial mood. So it falls into my puzzle game thing. Extract files. This one came with the Mac version as well, too. Run. Basically, it was made on a Mac because you get the Mac OS X files folders show up. Otherwise, I don't have the little file store things. Okay, ooh. Pretty. Let me wait for it to show up on here because I don't know. It doesn't always show up immediately. There we go. Is that a pretty title screen? Kind of nice ethereal music going on. Let's play. Gaia is out of harmony. Move the stones of resonance to soothe her temper and restore balance to the world. Oh, I see. Okay, so I have to try to get that. Okay. Oh. Okay, so we got our straight line. How precise I have to get it to match. Thing. I got something. Okay, I did something somewhere. Okay, so I'm figuring this out somehow. Okay, so there's actually a tone that seems to be guiding it. Okay. Oh boy, now we're starting to get things complicated here. Okay, so. Go. Okay, I'm starting to figure out some of the interface cues. There's a tone that say then gets louder and kind of closer as you get this piece to where it should go, and then they light up when they're in the position that they should be. So like this here, actually, I don't need to change. So it's like I can either work to try to match this pattern, or I could do it audibly. Thank you. that. Okay, so that's in its place now. I wish the music weren't as loud in this. There we go. Oh, there we go. Hey. That was kind of neat. That was pretty. I like that. The end. Okay. That was Resonance. Okay, I like that. Once you kind of figured out the interface clues it was giving you, that was a pretty neat kind of game. Okay, so we have one more game. Which apparently I also forgot to download last night. So let's quick grab that. One more game, and then we're going to call it a night. I have been streaming for almost 3 hours. These days I'll do a longer stream. It has to do marathons or something. Or at least longer streams. I may do it on a weekend, maybe a Sunday. Sunday night's still my Mass Effect. Yeah, I'll do like a long Mass Effect. When I get near the end of Mass Effect 1. Oh. Basic directory instead of doing another one. Okay. This game here is called the last game of the night, called Symphonic Sorceress. We'll read you the description. Going. Work. This is another one of the games where download data file with the EXE. So I just have an EXE. Doesn't work without any data. Yeah, I will not be playing the game. That's it. I need to run it. Yeah. In data folder. Okay. So, I guess with that, out of games to play. Sorry for that, I wanted to play this last one. A rhythm-based game about a sorceress traveling to different planets in the storyline to find her feline companion. Emmy. UXO. Okay, let's go see here or not. Download this. Let's big file. So yeah, this has been the Global Game Jam Games. Well, download. Okay, so actually, let me just finish reading. No point reading the description if I actually play the game. Okay. Have the file. The fun of live stream. Nope. Just A shame. My browser here or something. Side like that. Doesn't look like I'm going to play this here. Oh. I apologize for that. Okay, so yeah, I guess that's the end of my little game jam special here. It's been fun. Next year, Global Game Jam's happening about the same time. I hope to actually either participate or I'll be at least supervising at the library when it happens. But yeah, if you're interested in this, I suggest trying to find a local group that's doing it and try it out if you want to kind of really get into kind of making a game. No experience is necessary. If you don't have experiences, you can run onto a team that has some experienced developers. But that was fun. I mean, not all the games worked properly. Not all of them seemed to do much, but they were still kind of, it was still an entertaining evening. We got through that there. So, upcoming, I should be back to my regular streaming schedule now. So Friday night is kind of play anything I want. I'm still trying to figure out what I'm going to be playing Friday night. I'm kind of bouncing a couple different options, or main option I'm thinking about is it all depends on kind of how tired I'm feeling at the end of the week and after work and everything. If I'm pretty tired, I think I want to do something relaxing. I'm thinking about kind of starting up a Sims 4 game. So what I'll do is I'll go through and make like my main sim, and then we'll just go through and see what his life is like. Buy a house, we'll go do live his life, get him a job, do all that. I don't have any of the expansions yet for the game. I just have the basic game. I'm trying to think. I think I got it inexpensively on Origin. It was cheap, so I decided to buy it. I've played Sims 2, Sims 3. I think I have Sims 3. So I've played that. That might be fun. That might be, and it'll be just kind of something I can return to every so often. And we can kind of see how the little character is doing. So there's that. Another thing I've been thinking of is I have never played an Assassin's Creed game. And after I did go see the movie, I didn't think it was that great of a film. But it was a... one thing as I was watching the movie is like, wow, I think I really wanted to kind of try out the game. And when I kind of asked around to kind of see where I should start, because it's, what, like 13, 12, 13 games out now or something like that. Pretty much the resounding was start at the beginning. And a while ago, I got cheap on Amazon. Got, I think, Assassin's Creed 1 and 2. Might have 3 in there, too. I don't remember. So I got them cheap, and I have them on there. The first time I tried playing it... So when I said I never played an Assassin's Creed game, I kind of lied. I did start it, but I'm playing on the PC, and the mouse and keyboard controls for that game are absolutely insane. Like... there were like a dozen different keys that I had to press to do some things, and this was like basic things I'd be doing throughout the entire game. So I'm going to maybe try to fire, if I do decide to go that route, and I probably will at some point on the stream, play it. I will probably use the a gamepad, because I just feel that the game is better designed with kind of a more constrained set of buttons than a keyboard where you have to try to remember if you or I does something. So those are kind of the options I'm thinking about. And then Sunday, I'm going to be back to Mass Effect. We finished up Novaria last time I played. Pharos, and different assignments to do. Probably head back to the Citadel and kind of talk to some people. Maybe I'll take care of Pharos this Sunday night. But yeah, so I should be back to the normal schedule. Next Tuesday night is back to the Quirky Tuesday. I'm going to go back to the next big thing. Which I started last week, the last time I streamed. So that is that. And so now it's gotten late, and I think it's about time for me to call it a night. So nobody who came and watched this year, thank you very much. This has been just kind of a bunch of different games from Global Game Jams. As I said, I did post in the channel feed the link to the Google Doc that I had them all listed on there. This will be archived on YouTube and my YouTube channel. And all of those will be, and I'll list all the games in there too when I get that uploaded. So that's it. Thank you for watching, and have a good evening.